And something in the eyes are, you know, they talk about eyes being the windows to the soul.
When we first met with RA Friedman, it was summertime, mid-July.
I really felt, you know, you need to sit with these people. You need to honor them. You need to feel their pain.
We suspected we were in for a difficult few months, but what we didn't realize was that a year later, Friedman would still be sketching out the faces of our neighbors that COVID took too soon.
It's definitely the weight of this pandemic is definitely felt within the walls of this studio.
The collection, which now features more than 100 portraits from several artists, can be found under The Trouble I've Seen. But it's not just about seeing.
I also want them to feel a connection to the humanity of the people that I've drawn. The virus really knows no boundaries. It doesn't know national boundaries. It doesn't know boundaries of race or ethnicity, religion, philosophical background, spiritual background, sexual orientation, nothing.
It's his way of doing his part to separate each life from the hundreds of thousands that have been lost. Friedman's project is gaining momentum nationwide, the collection expanding to include COVID-19 victims from all over. He's created more than 50 of the portraits himself.
Did I get it right? You know, is this the spirit of the person? I'm also hoping that they feel like I caught a little glimmer of what these people were in life, and that someone out there that they may not even know kind of knows your family a little bit more than when they started.
Like the rest of us, he's hoping for the day when there are no new faces to draw, so we can all get back to knowing people in life, not death. Pamela Osborne, NBC 10 News.